When you have four certified laboratories with good staff and proper equipment that do find different results for your same product, how do you check who of them is correct? Hello, I'm Tom. Welcome to my channel where we talk about continuous improvement in an industrial setting. And this video will be a practical case that I actually did about Gage R&R in a ring trial setup, so round robin ring trial. I made videos about both of them, the method, so go check them out if you don't know what a Gage R&R or a ring trial is. And this is a nice practical example of when to use a Gage R&R type of methodology, how to set it up in practice. So what we had is this was a time that I was working in a factory, and we had suppliers that some of them were actually supplying directly to the factory, but a whole number of them were coming in through intermediate collection stations. So the milk from the supplier, from the farm, would go to a collection station. They would analyze the milk for us, we would do payment based on their results, and then in big tanker trucks, we move it to the factory. So far, so good. Now, the university of one of the regions, they also have a good laboratory, of course, and farmers would bring their milk there to check also a bit who is right. Is the factory paying me the correct amount of money? Which I think is a very smart thing to do. If you are a big supplier of milk, there is quite a bit of money in the correct analysis. But they were indeed getting some different results. Now, on another end, the factory would be checked by our local government analysis, our veterinary office in the city where the factory is. They would also check, are we putting the correct information on our products, but also are we paying our suppliers in a good way? They did not find a lot of differences, but also important, and we had to really trust this. We know that there is some product going out, so the mass balance doesn't always check out, but these intermediaries, well, one of them was ours, but it of course had their own staff, so it's always a bit far away. There might sometimes have been some trust issues. One of them was recently separated from our organization, therefore a separate entity. There was another one that was already a private company for many years. So these intermediaries were actually also not our organization, not the same laboratory as the factory. It was very interesting for us to do a check. We calibrated all of the equipment basically in the same way, so there should not be a problem. And they're also all certified. So how do you know which of these laboratories is correct? Because in practice, each laboratory will tell you that they have the golden standard. The university says we have the best technologists available, we have the best trained people, we are correct. The government laboratory says, well, we are the government, we are the official laboratory, so we are correct. Our factory laboratory also said, well, we are the people training all of them and we have the most experience, we are correct. And of course these were also proud enough to say that they did everything correct. So how to see who is indeed correct, and maybe is there just some variation in this testing method that pops up from time to time and that you simply have to accept as a statistical spread and not blame on a laboratory, but just take some of the bad and the good and know that statistically it will balance out again. For this, a very good system to use is Gage R&R, the repeatability, reproducibility of your analysis. And what we did is a setup where we made samples. Let's go into the practical details. Me with some of my team of the of this milk purchasing department, so not any of the quality departments here, so we were nice and separate. We went to one of these collection stations, and there in their laboratory we took the milk coming in and we made samples of a lot of milk. So we made from five supplier farms that we knew have a bit different contents in the milk, because always with a Gage R&R you would like to have the whole spread of your process that makes that you can compare the variation in the analysis with the variation in the actual product that you are getting in. So we took a number of supplier farms that we knew had a difference between what they would give us, And from each of those tankers of milk coming in, we took samples and we made sure that we had enough samples to supply all of these laboratories. So I wrote here that we had four laboratories. In practice, we actually had even six of them, because we tested with all of the underlying laboratories that we had in our organization. So we made two duplos of each of the samples for, in this example, four laboratories to analyze. So from each big pot of milk, you make eight small samples and you give them a number. This number only I knew, just to make sure that none of the laboratory staff would know what to expect, which milk was the same, because of course what they should do is the two samples that they would get from the same supplier, well, they should of course find the same result, right? But because of that, even those double samples have different code numbers. And well, then we gave it to the laboratory where we were anyway to analyze it. But we drove off. We sent some to the nearby university. We sent some to the other testing stations, back to the factory, back to the analysis center, the government laboratory. And they all did the analyses. So each of them was analyzing 10 samples. And they gave us the data, the content, fat protein content, of these 10 samples with the code numbers that they had been given. And afterwards, we could combine this and we could really put them back into order and put them on a line to also get the average for each of the samples, the spread, but also calculate, as in Gage R&R, the average spread that you get from one laboratory between each of their duplo samples, and also the average value that they would get for all of the 5 × 2 samples. When we did this, we could really see that in fact the duplo spread was very, very small. So these ones, they were really small, which is a good sign. It means at least that the laboratory, when they do an analysis, they do it exactly the same the next time. So the repeatability is very high. The same laboratory with the same person operating will get the same result from the same sample, which is very nice. The reproducibility here, well, that was a bit of a problem, but this of course was also a good thing, because we were testing where problems might occur, and we did see one here. So at the time, we didn't really publish our data too widely because of the conclusion that we drew, but these guys, they were actually a lot higher in all of the content values that they found. A lot higher than all of the other laboratories, including also this external state laboratory, including one of the external collectors. So what we saw when we excluded them from our data, we had a very good reproducibility as well. Reproducibility means that when you analyze a sample in this laboratory, you will get the same results when you analyze it in this laboratory. And that is, of course, what you want. That gives a very good confidence that you have the correct values, or at least that you can trust the same type of data. So basically, our conclusions from this pretty big test were that this whole group were very nicely aligned. We had very stable factors within the laboratories and between all of the laboratories. Now, you could, of course, say, well, maybe they were correct and all of you are trying to push down what you are paying to the supplier. Well, this can, of course, be. What we also saw, that in fact, the repeatability of this laboratory itself was also significantly worse than of the other laboratories. That did not give us any good reason to trust them more than all of the others. So that's a nice case of how we did a Gage R&R within a ring trial setup, testing multiple laboratories and testing them in such a way where you don't know on forehand who is the best. You do not have a golden standard. You just check, do they match in analyses with each other, and how does the difference between laboratories compare to the difference within a laboratory, and to the specifications, to the limits that you accept for variation in the analysis in the first place. So I hope this gives a bit of a feeling when you can use Gage R&R, especially in this case, between different laboratories, inspired you to also use this system. It is relatively easy to set up. Just know that you do need a lot of samples. You need to analyze a lot, and this was even on the low end. If you want better statistical results, increase sample sizes, but it's relatively easy to set up and very nice to draw conclusions and make sure that management, laboratories, suppliers, that they know that the system can be trusted, because a measuring system also needs to be checked from time to time. Now, if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already for nice videos about Lean, Six Sigma, types of problem solving. I will give some examples, I will give a lot of explanation, but also let me know which type of videos you would like to see. I'll be happy to make them for you. For now, I wish you the best of luck in your own measurement systems analyses, but also remember to enjoy any continuous improvement journey.